I think there's three issues. Besides the production delay, which isn't a big surprise given the level of automation that they've got with the Model 3 production, you know, we're looking at some price issues around Model S and Model X. And then the new issue that we brought up and have some material concern around is rare earth sourcing for the DC permanent magnet motor that they're using for the Model 3. As we look forward out at, you know, EV adoption accelerating and looking at what, you know, technologies other OEMs are using, it's very similar to this, and there's a limited supply with about 80% of production coming out of China. There's some potential issues around price and sourcing of those materials.
In terms of the goals, I mean, I understand that sliding that 5,000 unit target to the end of Q1 may not seem like a big deal in the big scheme of things, but on the conference call, there seemed to be some hesitation on the part of Musk to reaffirm the 10,000 unit target by the end of the year. Did you get that sense, and does that throw into question the timing of the three in total?
You know, I think what they're working through right now is understanding exactly what the problems are. I think they have a good feel for how they can get to 5,000, and those are real serious challenges. But then moving past that to the 10,000, I don't think they really know what the issues are going to be once they get it up and running at a little bit higher volume. And that's pretty normal for this sort of process. And I think we've got that reflected in our model, but that's something that I'm not sure investors really fully appreciate with the complexity of what they're up to.
Can we mine a little deeper into the whole concern about the earth metals here? You mentioned China being the issue and a lot of the supply coming out of there. Is it that there's not enough physical capacity to get enough out of the ground? Is it a political concern that China's going to control it or not allow it to be exported, hoard it for themselves as they try to build their electric vehicle market?
I think it's all of the above. So if we look at, you know, just existing mining capacity and moving into the actual magnet materials, there's a limited amount of supply, which has been pretty flat here for the last number of years. If we look back to 2011, there was a dispute between China and Japan, and we saw, you know, a tenfold increase in metals prices, which can, you know, turn into an issue from a sovereign perspective. So as we look forward, you know, there are a lot of actual materials around the world, including some materials in the Mountain Pass deposit here in the U.S., which was part of the Molycorp platform previously. But, you know, you have to ramp those capacities, and you have to be able to turn the actual metals into materials, which is not a trivial endeavor. And we know there's a lot of work being done on that, but there's also a lot of work being done on eliminating these materials from the design of the motors.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.